Financial literacy has become an immensely popular component of financial reform across the world. Here in Uganda, a number of programs have been conducted, especially by the private sector, to increase financial education at all levels of the economy. However, despite the huge amounts of money plowed into the program, still very few Ugandans are fluent in the language of money.
Teaching children at Nakasero Primary and Kampala Junior Academy to earn, save, spend and donate. Basic concepts which, because they're learning it at the age of 10, 11, because they're talking to their parents and their friends about it, it's going to have a long-term impact on their lives. And every year the program is growing.
Many of us adults don't really know how to spend our money or even save it. You earn a salary at the end of the month, and before the middle of the next month, you've run dry. But these children have acquired these skills at the age of 10 and 11. And we think that if we are to change our country, if we are to change our people, if we are to provide a saving culture, we need to work with the younger children.
While a number of children were trained how to earn and save money for future use, these two have been frustrated by their own parents, whom they accuse of taking their savings for personal use.
She can tell me, do you have 10,000? Then I say yes. Then she tells me, lend me, I'll give it back to you. I'm going to use it to buy like something, what she needs. Then she takes it, then she gives it back to me after.
Saved like 30,000. But as I save, my mom used them and said she's going to give them back during Christmas time. And I'm going to use like for Christmas and keep some for other future use.
Fortunately, some have been able to improve their lives with the little they save from their pocket money.
I've been saving in a piggy bank and you can't remove money from there. But I want to use that money for donating, and some I'm going to use it for spending.
Actually, what I learned in earning is all about hard work. As you work hard, you get. What you get is what you save.
The Director of Education Services in the KCCA, Juliet Namudu, says they are yet to inculcate financial education in the curriculums to equip students with relevant financial skills.
In terms of curriculum, we do have information about money and how it is spent. I think one of the components we really, really need to emphasize, and I hear you, is how do we save?
Prudential Insurance Company and KCCA seeks to sensitize children as young as 10 years on how best they can better their earnings and savings. Unlike Uganda, in countries like Israel, every child is entitled to a personal savings account on which government deposits a fixed amount of money every month. This way, a child is ensured of better economic times as they turn 18. As for the economy, the scheme helps bridge the economic gap between the poor and the well-to-do people. Rachel Nachuala for Urban TV.